made points at a different level, and but if you bring them all together, I think there's a massive agreement on various things. One, I'll just put it together, taking the points from everyone without actually attributing them. I mean, it's very clear that, you know, the sum today, the terror is follows a carrot and stick policy. Carrots for those who perpetuate terror in the form of MLAs, of embrace, of garlands, of rewards, of access, of being given, being emboldened and strengthened. That's a few. And then for the vast majority, there is this stick, which is militarized, which is violent, and which is very, very ruthless, as we can see. And the terror is being spread, and you could get it from a sense of from what the younger speakers today also said, that it's being spread by the various instruments that the Sangh Parivar has decided to control or to completely take over. And that is the police, which is obviously a target in itself, the judiciary, the educational and cultural institutions, to begin with, and of course then the minorities, but I'm talking at the moment of the institutions. And through that, then they spread, you know, there is, they're speaking in so many voices that it's almost impossible for the normal human being to keep track of those voices. The voices come, they move into attacks, they come into slander campaigns, they create terror, they attack individuals, they move after them either through the courts or through the law or through the police or through completely trumped up charges. Even as we speak in Outlook, Neha and the editor, there's a case against them in Guwahati for a report they did on the Sangh trafficking people, young girls from the Northeast. And they embroil everybody into a certain, and the people who are coming in their way, who stand in their way, they are the ones who are individuals. I mean, if Kanhaiya was arrested or others in JNU, it was not just as if it was, they knew what was happening. There was a clear design to go ahead and arrest and then build up the case of fabrication around it. They're fabricating. Who's going to unravel the fabrication? Who's going to bring it out? Who's going to open it and bring it out for the people to understand, and to understand the level of terror? The terror is not just the lynching. The lynching of, say, a flak or of the flogging of the Dalits is done at strategic levels to spread the terror even further. But it is surrounded, that incident, whichever incident we are talking of violence, is surrounded by terror before and after, of all kinds. I mean, the bureaucracy is terrorized. BJP MPs and ministers are to some extent terrorized when they don't follow the path very, very strictly. Those who didn't follow it very strictly have been thrown out. Opposition parties were terrorized until they came together and started speaking over a year ago. And individuals, of course, we know there's so many here, Tista is here, everyone's there. You know, it's been, they've really, really been pushed. And it is just this little fight back where more and more people now are joining. The Dalits in Gujarat have joined. The Muslims are too beaten, really. So they come behind everyone. Everybody has got now in India this identity crisis that if a Muslim leads from the front in a secular way, not the Owaisi way, you better watch out because it's going to unleash a Hindu backlash. So they've already achieved that. That's already been achieved by the kind of violence and the terror that has been created. So we have been in 2 years, if you look at it as just a reporter, we have been in perpetual conflict, we have been in perpetual war. There's been perpetual hate, anger, threats, abuse, attack. You're living in this environment of complete, as an individual without anybody around you, you're living in this environment of complete hate and insecurity. And where is it all moving? I think I can't better Sita on this, is that it's moving straight to changing the constitution, to changing the fundamentals of the Indian democracy, of moving us into another paradigm altogether. I mean, we were at a meeting with an RSS leader, not very much in favor. That's why he was there, that same meeting. And he talked about the Constitution of India and said that we stand by it. But when he was questioned, he said, for the moment. So there is this constant shift, and they're shifting us towards the right, and everybody who is seen to be coming in the way of that is the target group. And we know who are the, all the ones who have been targeted are the ones, and who have been victims of Sangh terror, are the ones who are coming in the way and who need to be neutralized. Whether it's FTII, whether it's Chauhan, whether it's the censor board, whether it's the vice chancellors of universities, and whether it's the students. They know exactly where to go and who to hit. And there is this whole fear constantly of terror. Terror is not just the lynching of one person. It's a complete system, institutional takeover that is taking place. And the fight thus is very, very hard and very strong. I mean, unfortunately, we are still, I feel, a little weak. We are ineffective. We are scattered. We are factional. And I'm talking of us and the political parties. And at a particular time when the media has given up, one of the institutions which can unravel this, which could, if today the media was the media that one thinks journalism should be, the fight would have been won, half won by us. But the media is the first institution taken over. And it's been completely terrorized. The corporates have been terrorized. The editors are terrorized. The journalist who speaks out a little bit, Outlook, with its sinking fortunes, hardly anyone is reading it, is now find itself embroiled in a case. The journalists who try to bring out stories from Bastar were completely, you know what happened to them? So they know that communication, the media, information, revolution, technology, internet, Facebook, that's the power which they have to control. So they don't have to take away Facebook from us because they're or Twitter from us because they're stronger on Twitter. Their trolls are there. They bought them. They take over that space. That is terrorizing it. A small individual who brings out a post and then finds 5,000 people behind him is terrorized. He doesn't know how to fight that abuse because he's a decent soul. So they're playing on the law and the decency and the people's commitment to democracy and in all that is good with complete viciousness, which is terror.